A 3D simulation that goes beyond reality. A revolution in DIY 5-axis machine simulation. If you use LinuxCNC, you should also use VISMACH. What the heck? It's not working at all anymore.
What are you doing?
Hey, Angel. VISMACH isn't working right.
VISMACH, what's that? Is it a new game or something?
No, it's way more important than that. Today's video is about LinuxCNC again. It's part of my ongoing project to build my dream 5-axis machine. And this time, the focus is on setting up LinuxCNC.
Sounds complicated. But, so what's this VISMACH thing? Still sounds like a game to me.
No, it's not a game. VISMACH is a 3D simulation tool specifically for LinuxCNC. It allows you to simulate LinuxCNC's movements using a 3D model.
Oh, I see. But why bother with a 3D model? Wouldn't it be easier to just run the real machine? Oh wait, I get it. Since your machine isn't finished yet, you're using the 3D model to pretend it's done and working, right?
What? No, that's not it. There's a real reason for this. LinuxCNC's sample configuration already includes VISMACH. So I've been tweaking it to create a realistic simulation. That way, it feels like the actual machine is running, even though it's not finished yet.
Sounds like exactly what I just said. That's just a way of escaping reality, isn't it?
Wait a minute. Angel, I've been struggling with setting up a LinuxCNC, and posting videos has been delayed. If viewers get bored and start unsubscribing, what are we gonna do? My revenue from YouTube will decrease and I won't be able to pay your part-time fee. Is that okay with you?
Oh, now I understand. That's serious. And here I was thinking your brain was just frozen from all the drinking you've been doing while trying to figure this stuff out. Okay, I'll help you.
Thanks.
VISMACH is seriously cool. VISMACH is stand for Virtually Inconceivable Super Mario Achievement Challenge. Trust me. If people don't watch this video till the end, they're gonna regret it forever. By the time you finish watching this video, you will be a VISMACH master second to none. I bet you'll be the hero that all beautiful women like me aspire to be. Subscribe to our channel now or you will miss a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Alright, this video is all about showing how awesome VISMACH really is. First of all, Angel seems to be a bit misunderstood, so I'll correct her. I think VISMACH stands for Visual Machine. In the first place, this is not about the Super Mario game. In short, it's incredibly useful, especially for 5-axis machines. The more I set it up, the more I realize its true value. Honestly, I've become a huge fan of this software. Let's take a look at VISMACH in action. Here's the default setup of VISMACH. When you move the machine, the 3D model replicates the movement exactly. If you properly set up the 3D model of your machine, you can check how it operates without even touching the actual machine. I use the sample configuration XYZSCTRT, but there are many others. If you want to actually use VISMACH too, choose the configuration you like best.
There are so many different samples. Various types of CNC machine configurations. There are also robot. I'd like to make a robot someday.
Once the 5-axis CNC machine I'm building now is finished, it might be interesting to make a robot. In this video, I will show you 3 benefits that I have found by actually setting up VISMACH. In addition, I will briefly explain how to customize VISMACH. Before I explain the benefits, first I need to set up a 3D model of my charcoal machine in VISMACH. Actually, I had more trouble setting this up than I expected, but I think it was worth it. Here's what it looks like. It's cool, right? It is a little difficult to adjust the viewing angle using the mouse. I'm running LinuxCNC on a Raspberry Pi 4, but it seems a little insufficient power to handle 3 models. Maybe Raspberry Pi 5 will work more comfortably. Let me now explain the benefits I have found in actually setting up VISMACH. 1. You can verify movements without running the real machine. Running the actual machine is the most accurate way to check. but if you accidentally crash it, you could damage parts or tools. With VISMACH, you can do interference checks and more, all without any risk to the real hardware.
I see. So it's not just a Super Mario game. It's actually really important.
Just looking at the simulation of the Axis interface on the left, it is not at all clear that the machine is crashing, but looking at the VISMACH simulation on the right, it is very clear that it is crashing. If you have ever used a CNC machine, you have probably crashed it at least once. To crash a machine is a lot harder than you think. That would be a terrific advantage if it could be avoided.
Yes, that's right. You're always crashing machines, and on those days, you're always drunk.
Hey, Angel. I'm not always crashing machines. It's just that it's happened a few times in my life. The second benefit is accurate simulation even with switchable TCP. I know some of you may not understand what I mean, so I will explain briefly. TCP mode refers to a method where the machine controls movement based on the tool center point, TCP, which is the tip of the tool. This allows for precise control, even on complex cutting paths. Switchable TCP enables the operator to change between different kinematic models or control methods during operation. This flexibility allows for optimal control in various situations, ensuring efficient and accurate machining. When I switch from the normal coordinate system to TCP mode, the tool suddenly jumps to a different position when using the simulation of the Axis interface. This is because the display coordinates of the Axis interface cannot be changed. So it is necessary to change the position of the tool. VISMACH can accurately simulate the tool's movement, even when you switch TCP modes.
Wait, so no more tools suddenly teleporting across the screen? That's awfully convenient for those of us who use switchable TCP.
Three. 3D models let you check from angles you can't see in real life. Exactly. And here's the third benefit. With a 3D model, you can check from angles you would never be able to see in real life. For example, you can hide any parts that are in the way and make it much easier to see what's happening. You can even design parts of the machine to be stronger, which might block visibility. But with the simulation, you can see everything clearly. It's impossible to do that with the actual machine. Take a look at this. Now the machining program is running. I want to check the machining situation, but when the table is almost perpendicular to the Z-axis, the machine frame is in the way and I can't see the machining situation very well. I can't do anything about it because of the structure of this machine. To improve visibility, the top of the frame has been slightly concaved, but this is the limit. So which angle is the most ideal? Axis A rotates 90 degrees. Considering the position of the spindle, the ideal way to view the movement is from the direction of this arrow. In order to see from this angle, remove all the 3D models that are in the way. The spindle was also in the way, so I erased most of it. Spindle decided to make a special 3D model. If all the spindles were erased, it would be impossible to check for interference. So I made the outline of the spindles visible. It already has a perfect 3D model, but I commented out the settings so that it would not show up.
This is the one I don't like. I don't like these things with lots of text on them. I don't understand the meaning at all.
You don't have to hate it so much. It is written in a programming language called Python. But you don't need to understand the Python program to use VISMACH. You just need to know what to do to set up VISMACH. That's pretty easy. I was able to set it up even though I don't understand Python at all.
Are you sure?
I have to honestly say that I had a lot of trouble setting up VISMACH, but now I can say it's easy because I know what I need to do. Anyway, I finished changing the settings. Here is what it looks like after the change. What do you think? Isn't it very easy to see?
It's nice. I can see the part I want to see from the angle that's most convenient for me to see. Indeed, I can accurately check the operation from angles that I can't see on the actual machine.
Yes, I know. After seeing this, I felt that VISMACH was more important than I thought it was. So I decided to introduce it to other freaks in the world like me. I'm not such a great creak. I'm just a drunken freak who is everywhere. By the way, this demo program is for switchable TCP. But let's take a look at some other demo programs that work a bit interesting. This is like a program for an impeller created in CAM. This is a typical program that can only be done with 5 axes. It looks and feels great. We can say that 5-axis CNC machines are built for this kind of machining. This is a very beautiful movement.
Oh yeah, I know, because people always tell me that my movements look so beautiful to men. Well, I'm an angel. So I guess I'm phenomenally beautiful compared to humans. But it's a little embarrassing to get that many compliments from you. But thanks.
Angel, I'm sorry, but I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about the movement of the machine.
Anyway, it's kind of nice.
VISMACH is configured as a Python program and is loaded via the .ini file in LinuxCNC. There are two main approaches to setting up models in VISMACH. The first approach is using geometric shapes. In this method, you define 3D objects such as boxes, cylinders, and spheres in Python code, and create a model by assembling these basic shapes. For example, a box-shaped base or a cylindrical spindle can be represented using primitives like box and cylinder. The second approach leverages 3D CAD software. By importing STL or OBJ files created in tools like Fusion 360, you can visualize more complex shapes and realistic models. This method allows you to use actual design data directly, enabling efficient and detailed simulation. The models created through either approach are linked to HAL, Hardware Abstraction Layer, PENS, which allows real-time simulation of the model's movements. This makes it possible to intuitively understand the behavior of the actual machine being simulated.
In short, to use the 3 model of the machine I designed, I edit the Python file specified in the .ini file and specify the file of the 3D model.
Well, that's how it is in a simplified way. I know many people will not be able to understand everything just from the explanation I just gave, so I'll put links to manuals and other information in the overview section. The purpose of VISMACH is to test the operation and control system of a machine in 3D with animation and to verify the actual operation in real time. Of course, I use VISMACH for that purpose as well, but as I have explained, I focus on its merits as a machining hobby ration. I will now explain some interesting things to use VISMACH more comfortably as a machining simulation tool. The purpose of VISMACH is to test the operation and control system of a machine in 3D with animation and to verify the actual operation in real time. Of course, I use VISMACH for that purpose as well, but as I have explained, I focus on its merits as a machining hobby ration. I will now explain some interesting things to use VISMACH more comfortably as a machining simulation tool. Look at this. All useless parts have been removed to make it easier to check the machining status.
That way I can check for interference from any angle. Since the only possible interference is with the spindles and tilt table, only those should be displayed. This is very reasonable. By the way, what is this red square?
That's a good question. It shows the machining range. It shows the range of motion of the X, Y, and Z axes.
I see. So if there is something to be machined in here, it can be machined.
You're right, Angel. You're quick to understand. I also want to emphasize a point. It's that this machining range is shifted by the length of the tool. Look at this. When I change the tool, the machining area also shifts. That means that it shows the actual machining range even if the tool is changed.
That's great. It's very useful to easily see the range that each tool can machine. But isn't it difficult to set up something like this?
If you know how to use Fusion 360 and know how to do a basic VISMACH setup, it's not that hard.
If you've made it this far, you should probably set up the actual parts and fixtures right.
You're right. But it is not enough. Let's think deeper. The fixtures and parts need to be changed depending on what you want to machine. If possible, wouldn't it be nice to be able to recall various VISMACH setups whenever you want?
Yes, I think so. But isn't it difficult to set up something like that?
I tried various methods and went through a lot of trouble, but in the end, the easiest and most user-friendly way was to create shortcuts on the desktop. It looks like this. You can even set up a photo for the shortcut so you can immediately see what the configuration looks like. You can set up as many configurations as you like, such as a setting dedicated to machining simulation or a perfect simulation of a machine. Anything you want.
I like VISMACH. It's so cool.
I know. I didn't expect this when I started setting up VISMACH either. But as it turns out, I found VISMACH to be very useful. This is with the E40 collet chuck attached to the C-axis. I plan to use this to hold the material in place for machining. Let's set a 26mm shaft with a 40mm protrusion in this collet chuck. It looks like this. If I actually mounted the shaft in this chuck, it would look something like this. The size of this material can be changed immediately by simply modifying the values in the Python file a little. Next, let's set a sheet metal of 3mm thick, 80mm wide, and 160mm long. It seems a little too large for this machine, but let's give it a try. Surprisingly, there seems to be no interference. I set up the angel as a thing to be machined.
Oh my gosh, what a sweet angel. She looks just like me, and he's got those cute little wings. Are you trying to make this for me?
No, just found it online. Just wanted to set this up as something to machine. Let's run the end mill.
What on earth did you do? Hey freak, you just end milled my head.
Sorry, I didn't do it on purpose. Look closely, the angel's head is outside the machining area. The angel head was too big for the end mill to avoid.
What a stupid thing to say. What do you mean my head is too big for my supermodel-like figure? What did you do now? You stirred my brain with an end mill. What if brain juice comes out of my nose?
Sorry. That was on purpose. I was just trying to do that. It didn't mean anything in particular. But I don't want to see your brain juice because it's disgusting.
Hey freak, please wait for me to stick about 200 end mills in your head someday.
It is time to end this video because my life is now in danger. This video was about LinuxCNC's VISMACH. But remember, this video is part of a DIY 5-axis CNC project. If you are interested in this project, I suggest you subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any videos. If you empathize with my project, why don't you become a member and support this channel? There are a few benefits, but as long as you are a member, your name will appear at the end of the videos as a patron. In other words, you can be a part of this project. So, please look forward to the next video.